iniquity of their fathers and their trespass which they trespassed against me, and they also that they also have walked contrary unto me, and that I also have walked contrary unto them, and have brought them into the land of their enemies, if then their uncircumcised hearts be humbled, and they then accept the punishment of their iniquity, then will I remember my covenant with Jacob, and also my covenant with Isaac, and also my covenant with Abraham, and I will remember, and I will remember the land. The book of Leviticus is completed with the Lord's instructions on the valuation of people, property, and land that is dedicated to him and to his temple. These are the commandments of the Lord that the Lord commanded Moshe to the children of Israel on Mount Sinai. The off-Torah portion is taken from Jeremiah chapter 16 and 17 and is at a time when the sin of Judah was out of control and has taken the place where God once stood in their lives. How they were seeking and trusting in the counsel of the nations around them, God through Jeremiah rebukes the people for the abominations and idols that have been set up in the land. But then the Lord reveals to those in Judah who are blind and have been taken hold of their worsening state, and that is, blessed is the man that trusteth in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is, for he shall be as a tree planted by the waters, and that spreadeth out her roots by the river, and shall not see when the heat cometh. But her leaf shall be green, and shall not be careful in the year of drought, neither shall cease from yielding fruit. Birkat HaShah this week was taken from Galatians chapter 4, where we see Paul reprimanding and correcting the church of Galatia for regressing away from the gospel that was initially taught to them by Paul. How they have begun to believe that it is by the works of the law that they are justified before God. Paul changes his tone with them and sternly teaches them again that it is by faith in Yeshua alone that justifies them before God, and that they are all heirs to the promise, not of bondage, but of freedom, comparing these two different covenants symbolically with the sons of Abraham, who were born one under bondage or slavery and the other under freedom and promise. As Paul says, "So then, brethren, we are not children of the bondwoman, but of the free. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage." Amen. All right, shofarim.
Praise you, Yeshua. We just love you. We worship you today. And we thank you for such a beautiful day, Lord. Father, I just pray for your anointing to flow through this place. I pray that you touch the people. And Lord, especially today, Lord, as the world acknowledges the mothers, and which I think is a beautiful thing to do, Lord. We want to acknowledge the mothers because tomorrow is Mother's Day. So today will be ours. So Lord, I pray, Father, for a blessing upon them. I thank you for every mother here, every grandma, every child. And Lord, I thank you for the fruit of this congregation, Father. I ask, Lord God, that you touch each one according to your blessings that you pour out upon us, Father, according to your word. We love your word, Lord. Your word is holy. And we give you praise and honor today. And we ask, Father, that you would have your way today in all things, in our worship, in our conversation, in the word that comes forth. We just pray, Father, that you will be blessed. In Yeshua's name, amen.
Amen. Let us stand together. For how lovely are the tents of Jacob and the dwelling places of Israel. Matovu, Halecha, Yaakov, Mishkenote, Kais. Therefore, with joy shall we draw water from the wells of Yeshua. Amen and amen. And you may be seated.
And we begin the Siddur with the Baruch Hu. Baruch Hu et Adonai Hamvarach. Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Vayed. Bless the Lord, the Blessed One. Blessed is the Lord, the Blessed One, for all eternity. The children of Israel shall keep the Shabbat, observing it throughout their generations as an everlasting covenant. It is a sign between me and the children of Israel forever, for in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, and on the seventh day he rested and was refreshed. And it shall come to pass that from one new moon to another, and from one Shabbat to another, all flesh shall come to worship before me, says the Lord. Blessing Mashiach Yeshua together. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu et derech ha-yeshua b'mashiach Yeshua. Amen. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who has given us the way of salvation in Messiah Yeshua. Amen. We all stand for the Shema.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kavod Malki.
Blessed be the name of his glorious kingdom forever and ever. Amen. Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha b'kol levavka v'kol nafshecha v'kol modecha v'hayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anoki matzavka hayom al levavecha v'shinatan levenecha v'dabarta bam v'shivtecha v'peveteka uvletka v'aderek uvshapka uvkumecha uksharatam le'ot ayadecha v'hayu le'tufo b'enenecha uktatam uzot peteka uvishrecha. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. And these words which I command you this day shall be upon your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children and shall speak of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. You shall bind them for a sign upon your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. You shall write them upon the doorposts of your house and on your gates. Ve'ahavtam l'reacha kamocha. And you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Amen. Blessed are you, O Lord our God and God of our fathers, God of Abraham, God of Yitzchak, and God of Yaakov, the great, mighty, and awesome God, the most high God who bestows grace and creates all, and remembers the kindnesses of the fathers, and brings a redeemer to his children's children for his name's sake with love. O King, helper, Savior, and shield, blessed are you, O Lord, shield of Abraham. You are eternally mighty, my Lord, the resurrector of the dead are you, abundantly able to save, who sustains the living with kindness, resurrects the dead with abundant mercy, supports the fallen, heals the sick, releases the confined, and maintains his faith to those asleep in the dust. Who is like you, O Master of mighty deeds, and who is comparable to you, O King, who causes death and restores life and makes salvation sprout? Our God and God of our fathers, may be pleased with our rest. Sanctify us in your commandments and grant us our portion in your Torah. Satisfy us from your goodness and make us rejoice in your salvation. And purify our hearts to serve you in truth, in love and favor. O Lord our God, grant us a holy Shabbat as a heritage. May Israel, who sanctifies your name, rest therein. Baruch atah Adonai, Mekadesh HaShabbat. Blessed are you, O Lord, who makes the Shabbat holy. Magnified and sanctified be his great name in the world which he has created according to his will. May he establish his kingdom during your life and during your days and during the life of the whole house of Israel, and swiftly and soon, and all say, Amen. Let his great name be blessed forever and to all eternity. Blessed, praised, and glorified, exalted, extolled, and honored, magnified and lauded be the name of the Holy One. Blessed is he, though he be high above all blessings and songs, praises and consolations which are uttered in the world, and all say, Amen. May he who makes peace in his high places make peace upon us, upon all Israel, and say, Amen, Amen. Yit gadol v'yit gadol shemer abam. Amen.
O say shalom bimrumam, hu yase shalom aleinu, ve'acho Yisrael, vimru, imru, amen. O say shalom bimramam, hu yase shalom aleinu, ve'acho Yisrael, vimru, imru, amen. Yase shalom, yase shalom, shalom aleinu, v'yacho Yisrael. Yase shalom, yase shalom. Shalom aleinu, v'yacho Yisrael. Yase shalom, yase shalom. Shalom aleinu, v'yacho Yisrael. Yase shalom, yase shalom, shalom aleinu, v'yacho Yisrael. May he who makes peace in high places make peace for Israel and for all mankind, and say, Amen. Thank you. Awake in the heavens, standing before you, pour out your glory on us. Oh, shake earth's foundations, gather the elders, call forth your servants to praise. Oh, we are all gathered around your mountain, and we are assembled to call for the nations. Usher in your presence, release your anointing. Father, release your King.
Call forth the nations, usher in your presence, release your anointing, Father, release your kingdom. We are assembled, call forth the nations, usher in your presence.
Holy is the Lord on high.
smooth the fields before you. Oh, and we crown you highest of all. Glory to the risen King. Glory to the Son, glorious Son. Lift up your head, open the door. Let the King of glory come in and forever be our God. Lift up your heads, open the doors. Let the King of glory come in and forever be our God. Glory to the risen King. Son, glorious Son, lift up your head, open the door, let the King of glory come in, and forever be our God. Lift up your heads, open the door, let the King of glory come in, and forever be our God.
He is our faithful Father, calling us out of the dark. Oh, and I cannot whisper away what He says in the light. Oh, He is our firm foundation, our anchor won't be moved. Oh, storms may collide, but my soul is on fire as a word.
Listen to the sound of power on our lips. Yeshua has broken the curse. He has never lost a battle. Who are you, great mountain, that you should not bow low? Yeshua defeated the darkness. He has never lost a battle.
He is the only healer. His love will never fail. Oh, all my belief dares to defeat every lie. He is a strong high tower. Fear will not find me there. Oh, I come alive in His promise inside of me. Oh,
when listen to the sound of power on our lips. Yeshua has broken the curse. He has never lost the battle. And who are you, great mountain, that you should not bow low? Yeshua defeated in the darkness. He has never lost a battle. When listen to the sound of power on our lips. Oh, Yeshua's broken the curse. He has never lost a battle.